Salam alaikum. Labas, bakhir, kidera. It's me, Nicola, English woman, abroad in Morocco, still in Adilau. When we spoke before, I talked a little bit about Darija. I told you my journey in Morocco in Darija, and I said that I would tell you a bit more about the Darija that I have learnt over the last few months. So this is it. I'm going to tell you some of the things that I've learnt in the Darija language. So to begin with, Darija is a form of Arabic and it is spoken just in Morocco. I think even Arabic speakers in other parts of the world find it hard to understand Darija. So it's quite different from Arabic. It also has some sounds which are quite difficult for me because I don't have them in my language. So there are some sort of guttural and sounds which I struggle a little bit with. So some words are easier for me than others. But the first word I think that I learnt when I came here, and for those of you again who've been here or who live here, you'll know that food is a very important part of the culture here, and everyone wants to feed you all the time. If you're at the table and you haven't got food in both your hands and in your mouth, they will try and feed you more. So it was very important for me to be able to say, actually, I've had enough, thank you very much. So balak shokran, I've had enough, I don't want any more, thank you. Or shpit, I'm full up, thank you. So that was one of the first two words that I learned. My very first visit here, almost 2 years ago now, I learned a word that became quite important. So walking the streets of the Medina, I learned the word balak, which means essentially get out of the way, having almost been trampled on by a donkey and cart. Because whilst I heard somebody shouting balak, balak behind me, I didn't actually understand what it meant. And somebody afterwards said to me, you know, balak, or the donkey will balak you. So it's like, get out of the way or the donkey's going to trample you. They don't stop for anybody. So those are some of the first words I learned. When I spent a bit more time here, I learned words like yalla, mashina. And my understanding of that to start with was, let's go, you know, it's time for us to go, let's get up and go. But it became apparent after spending some time here that it was me that got up and went, and everybody else kind of sat and carried on talking, and I would be stood with my coat and shoes on by the door, and everybody else is kind of slowly making their way to the door, talking a little bit more at every step. You know, when we put our shoes on, let's talk a little bit more, let's put our coat on, talk a little bit more. So yalla mashina, not quite what I thought it was, but still some sort of indication that at some point in the future, the future to be determined, we're not quite sure how long that future will be, we get up and go. So now I wait till everyone else has got their shoes and coat on and a bit closer to the door before I start to get up and get ready to go. So I got stuck in the UK for 6 months. I had been in Morocco, went home March 2020, just before everything kind of shut down. And I got stuck in the UK for about 6 months. So I spent that time using some tools, some videos and stuff on the internet to try and learn some other words in Darija. There's a lot of information out there, so it's been quite a journey for me. I've learned a little bit of Arabic. I've learned to write a little bit of Arabic, and also to speak a little bit of Darija. So where next? Days of the week, maybe. I think, you know, when anybody's learning a language, those are the kinds of things that you start with. So days of the week, tnin, tlat, arba, lakhmis, jumaa, subt, alhud. I think everyone can work out what those days are. And numbers, I think, again, everyone starts with counting. It's a good place to start with a language. So I can count at least up to 100, but I'm not going to do that for you today, so I'll just do up to 10 for you. So, واحد, 1, زوج, 2, ثلاثة, 3, أربعة, خمسة, ستة, سبعة, ثمانية, تسعة, عشرة. So, you can work out for yourself whether the pronunciation is any good. And as I say, I could go on. So, in the market, what do we hear in the market? We hear people shouting out, Matisha, Matisha, Batata, Psla. So, that's tomatoes, potatoes, and all sorts of other vegetables. Khizu, Hudra, vegetables. So, khizu being carrots. Other things I've learnt, colours. So, khel, bied, kwa. Kawa, that reminds me of my journey to the coffee shop. Probably a lot of days I've been to the coffee shop since I've been here. And in Arabic, coincidentally, the name of the coffee shop is the same as the name of the coffee, so kawa. And I quickly learned to ask for kawa plus sukar, afek. So coffee with no sugar, thank you very much. Sugar's a staple in food, drink, pretty much everything here, and clearly quite simple for us. Sukar, sugar, very similar. Sometimes I have a nusnus coffee in the coffee shop, and that literally translates to half and half, so half coffee and half milk. What else have I learned? So when I get up in the morning, I have my fitor, which is breakfast. And for a lot of Moroccans, breakfast consists of hubs, bread, and another word you'll learn very quickly in Morocco, bread eaten at every meal, hubs, with a little bit of zid or olive oil, and ate. Again, maybe simple connection there with tea, but not quite the same, certainly, as the tea that we have in the UK. Okay, so what else? One other thing that's very important, of course, for me to know is how to say, I don't understand. So, mafhemsh was quite important for me. And it's quite useful when I went to the Masimin shop the other day and I had a nice little list all prepared of what I was going to ask for. Masimin with fromage, Masimin toute option, and the man didn't understand what I was asking for, and I couldn't understand him when he told me they didn't understand. So mafhemsh has been quite useful for me, and I have used that quite a lot to explain to people that I can't understand what they're saying. Moroccans speak very quickly, so even when you think you know words, when they're pronounced and spoken in general conversation, it's sometimes hard to pick out the individual words. So another thing that I found quite funny here, and I didn't realise for quite a long time, is the word for donkey in Morocco is khamar. And I heard people, like, you know, when somebody was doing something stupid or wrong, calling someone khamar and thinking that these were two separate words that weren't connected, and that somehow hamar was pronounced in a slightly different way and it meant something else. But I discovered that actually Moroccans call what they think are stupid people donkeys. And so now whenever I think of that word, it makes me laugh. Hamar. Why would you call someone a donkey? I don't know. But then actually I remembered that in the UK, we actually use the word ass, which is a type of donkey for somebody who is being stupid or doing something that they shouldn't be doing. So maybe it's not as daft as it seems. What else have I learnt since I've been here? Okay, so that's pretty much it for now. One thing that I will ask of my Moroccan friends out there, I need you to reply to this, tikshbila, and I'll explain that to everybody else in my next Darija video. So subscribe to the channel if you want more information. Comment, tell me what you want to hear, tell me what you want to know, and I'll speak to you again soon.